Hello students, welcome back to mathematics class session number 2. Okay, in today's class let us continue some of the problems of exercise number 3.5. Okay, let us see it now. For which value of k will the following pair of linear equations have no solution? Okay, so for which value of k means what you have to find, the value of k here. Yes, that is for parallel lines. What is the condition for parallel lines? Here you have seen. See here, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. Okay, so this is the condition for no solution. No solution. Whenever they can specify some condition, that we have to write in the form of ratio. Infinitely many solutions, that means condition what is there for infinitely many solutions, that will no solution, that means what is the condition for no solution, that will have to write. Is it okay? Now the condition is for no solution. No solution means what you have read, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. That condition I have to take here to get the value of k. Okay, children, how can I write? First, bring everything into same side. We need a general form of a pair of linear equations. For that sake, plus 1 bring here, it will become minus 1. And even 2k plus 1 bring here, minus 2k plus 1. Okay, how can I write that? See here, first general form write down 3x plus 1 by plus 1 coming here minus 1 is equal to 0. Yes, sir. Even here 2k minus 1 x plus k minus 1 y. This is binomial. When I bring here, I put minus sign and the bracket you have to put. Okay, even binomial and binomial there, you have to put the bracket here. Okay, so 2k plus 1 is equal to 0. This is the standard form of a pair of linear equation. Okay, now we can find the ratios. Like that ratio of red, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. For no solution, no solution set means that ratio I have to write here. Can I write that here? See now, how to find the value of k using that ratio? See, write that here. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. It's a condition for no solution. No solution. In fact, means immediately this ratios you have to write. Okay, children, for parallel lines, there is no solution. Now, who is A1? 3. A2, 2k minus 1. X place x, see x, x, 3. 3 by 2k minus 1. Y and y coordinates, what is there? 1 by k minus 1. 1 by k minus 1 is not equal to minus 1 by minus 2k plus 1. Not equal, also you have to write that. Okay, ratio. See here, A1 means 2, 3. A2 means 2k minus 1. 2k minus 1. Write below here. 3 by 2k minus 1. Children, 2k minus 1. X and x leave. That is the x coordinate not to write. Only the coefficients of x who are there, that we have to write like this. Okay, so which are the coefficients of y? They are 1 and k minus 1. Right here is equal to 1 by k minus 1. Okay, then is equal to minus 1 is not equal to, because the solution is no solution, no? So not equal to C1 by C2 can be written as minus 1 by minus 2k plus 1. See, write properly. 3 by 2k minus 1 1 by k minus 1 minus 1 by minus 2k plus 1. These are the constants, right? One below the other. Is it okay, children? So now what can I do? Well, comparing now, all three are don't have a equal sign. This is not equal. So when there is a not equal sign, you have to compare these and this, not this. Is it okay? They only say don't want. Let not equal to. Not equal to means that condition cannot be taken. Okay, so now what can I take? These two conditions equal. This is there. No, that condition take and find the value of k. Find the value of k. So write that condition. You understand, children? Is not equal mentioned means not equal mentioned means what can you write? These two fractions are equal. Means I can write this one not needed. Not needed. Okay. So 3 by 2k minus 1 is equal to 1 by k minus 1. So these two ratios, they means you have write here and you have to cross multiply. You have to cross multiply. So cross it. Okay, so how can I cross? I'll cross in 3 into k. 3k, 3 ones are 3. For both you have to multiply. So 3 into k, 3k minus 3 ones are 3 is equal to 2k minus 1 ones are 2k minus 1 ones are 2k minus 1. Is it okay? Now we have children, 3 into k, 3k minus 3 ones are 3 is equal to 2k minus 1 ones are 2k minus 1. Okay, now k and k bring into same side. To get the value of k, I have to compare these two only, not this and this. Because they are not equal. Mentioned they are not equal. So don't compare. Equal middle there is to compare. Okay, children. So I will compare these two. Now see here, 3 into k, 3k minus 3 ones are 3 is equal to 2k minus 1 is 2k minus 1. 3k and 2k bring it to same side. So 3k is already here, plus 2k coming here, minus 2k is equal to, 2k went there, is already here, minus 1, right? Minus 3 going that side, plus 3. Minus 3 going that side, plus 3. Is it okay? Now, 3k minus 2k, how many k's are there? 3 minus 2, 1k. 1k, 1 plus, 1 minus, you have to subtract. 3 minus 1 is 2. Bigger number sign is plus. What is the value of k? K is equal to 2. Like this, this will come for 2 mark for the examination. This is okay, very, very important problem. So this problem and the previous problem, you have to learn properly. Is it okay, children? So this is the form how to find the value of k. Okay, so that's all about this problem. Okay, let us move to next problem now. Now, write third bin. Okay, third bin. Third bin, what can I use here? Write third bin. Solve the following. Solve the following, solve the following pair of linear equation, pair of linear equation, solve the following pair of linear equation, equations by cross multiplication method, cross multiplication. Cross multiplication method. Okay, for example, which method they mentioned, with that method you can do. If at all they did not mention any of the method, you can do which you feel very easier. Okay, children. So now let us find it by cross multiplication now. So what is the question? See here. Question is 8x plus 5y is equal to 9. Then 3x plus 2y is equal to 4. Okay, so first bring it to general form. Everything bring it to same sign. Okay, so now it is 8x plus 5y plus 9 coming here. Put the arrow mark so that you understand you are bringing it to another side. And you have to change its sign. Plus 9 coming here, minus 9 is equal to 0. Say, while doing it, bringing it here, you say it. Okay, then you will change the sign. Otherwise, you write plus sign itself. Okay, that should not be. Now, see here, next one, dx plus 2y plus 4 coming here, minus 4 is equal to 0. Okay, now what can I do? I can use cross multiplication. Okay, for that say, I have to write here x. Okay, then I write here y. Here I write constant 1. Okay, so there afterwards. Now, x keep in disguise. Okay, these two terms you will take. So that is 5, 2, minus 9, minus 4. Okay, then y keep like this. Y next number what? Minus 9, minus 4, 8 and 3. Even this keep in disguise. These two terms you have to take. That is 8, 3, 5, 2. Okay, if you hold it here, you can understand it very clearly. So what is that? 5, 2. 5, 2, minus 9, minus 4. Okay, so then even y keep like this, minus 9, minus 4, 8, 3. Okay, even keep like this, 8, 3, 5, 2, plus, no, so no tension. Okay, now fine. Now what we can do, we can cross multiply like this. We can cross multiply now, x, y, just multiply this, 5, 4, 7. 5 4s are 20 minus 20. My middle sign is minus. 9 2s are 18 minus 18. Okay, then it is equal to y right as it is. 9 3s are 27 minus bracket. 8 4s are 32. Middle sign is, sorry, 8 4s are 32. Minus 32. Middle sign anyhow minus only. Is it over here? 8 4s are 32. Minus 32 is equal to 1 by 8 2s are 16. Minus 5 3s are 15. 8 2s are 16. 5 3s are 15. Middle sign is minus. Okay, children. Now solve this. So now see here, what to write? X by minus 20 as it is here. Minus into minus plus 18 is equal to y right as it is. Y right as it is minus 27. Minus 27. Minus into minus. Minus into minus plus 32 is equal to 1 by 16 minus 15. 16 minus 15 is 1. Okay, so now solve here. Yes, y. 1 minus 1 plus, you have to subtract. Okay, 20 minus 18, 2. Bigger number sign. Minus, then is equal to y. By 1 plus 1 minus, you have to subtract. 27, 30, 32, how much? 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 5. Bigger number sign is plus. Is equal to 1 by 1 is 1. 1 by 1 is 1. By comparing first and the last term you have to compare. Second and the last term you have to compare. Okay, so comparing means what, children? X by minus 2 is equal to 1. Even y by 5 is equal to 1. Y is equal to 1. Okay, comparing time, first and the last term write together. Second and the last term write together with equal sign. Okay, thereafter, just cross it. So, x is equal to minus 2, 1 is a minus 2. Minus 2, 1 is a minus 2. Y is equal to 5, 1 is a 5. 5, 1 is a 5. Like this, I can get the value of x and y. Hope you all understood this, children. Is it okay? So now, see, same question we can do with the substitution method. If you do with the elimination method or substitution method, you will get the same answer. Okay, try this with the that two methods. Hope you are getting the same answers. Okay, so that's all about this problem. Hope you all understood. Okay, so now let us move to verbal problems. Let us move to verbal problems. How can we do this problem? See here, what is the problem? Okay, first we will do in this second. A fraction becomes 1 by 3. A fraction becomes 1 by 3. Fraction becomes 1 by 3 when 1 is subtracted, 1 is subtracted from the numerator. From the numerator, a fraction becomes 1 by 3 when 1 is subtracted from the numerator. Subtracted from the numerator, and it becomes 1 by 4 and it becomes 1 by 4 when 8 is added to the denominator. Find the fraction. Okay, children. So let us do it now. So first, what can we do? See here, a fraction becomes 1 by 3 when 1 is subtracted from the numerator, and it becomes 1 by 4 when 8 is added to the denominator. Find the fraction. Okay, so two cases are there to get the two linear equations. Okay, now what you have to see here? A fraction. Whenever there is a fraction sum comes, fraction, how can I form? One numerator and one denominator is a numerator by denominator forms a fraction. Okay, so let the numerator, so two terms need only one more problem. So numerator is taken as x and the denominator is taken as y. So the fraction become x by 1. So how to try? Let the numerator be x, let the denominator be y. Similar, like these problems many I have done. Yes, no, please practice at home. Okay, that is only the solution to get the water tension in maths. Only practice. Okay, see here, numerator is x and denominator is y. Then the fraction becomes x by y. So you have right here, let the numerator be, x, let the numerator be x, and the denominator be, y. Okay, then the fraction becomes, fraction becomes x by y, So this much is every time say numerator x, denominator y, fraction become x by y. This carry half mark, children. You have to understand. So fraction immediately can write x by y. Now what you can do see here, a fraction becomes 1 by 3. A fraction becomes 1 by 3 when 1 is subtracted from the numerator. So children, 1 is subtracted from the numerator. 1 is subtracted from the numerator. 1 is subtracted from the numerator means, see, from numerator, yes, you have to subtract 1. What number says it? 1 is subtracted from the numerator. Numerator is called as x. X minus 1. But did they give anything about denominator? Given. But it is another question. See, this is another question. Is it okay, children? Denominator, nothing given. So you have to write as is y. Is it okay? See, fraction becomes 1 by 3 when 1 is subtracted from the numerator. 1 is subtracted from the numerator. Denominator, they did not mention anything. Write as it is. Okay. So now this is one equation to get method. This is the first sentence meaning. Second sentence meaning what is there? And also it becomes 1 by 4. It is becoming 1 by 4 when see, 8 is added to the denominator. 8 is added to the denominator. Denominator, you have to add 8 to 6. Which is the denominator? Why? For why you have to add 8? Okay. So, for numerator, they did not mention anything here. For denominator, you have to add 8. That's the sentence here. See, the fraction becomes 1 by 4. Yes, 1 by 4. When 8 is added to the denominator, 8 is added to the denominator, numerator cannot do anything because it did not say anything. Is it okay here? Denominator not mentioned, so wrote y. Here numerator not mentioned, so wrote x. Okay, what sentence you have like that only try to do, children. Okay, it's not so difficult. So now what you have to do? Just cross multiply. Fractions are the means of cross multiplication. Even here cross multiplication. So that you get pair of linear equations. Okay. So now cross it. Cross by the mean what you have to do. See here, just multiply both. 3 into x. 3x. Minus 3 ones are 3. All will do mistake here only. We will just multiply 3 with the x, not with 1. Wrong it is. Okay, just multiply it properly, children. Okay, 3 into x, 3x, 3 1 is 3 is equal to y 1 is y. So then here, 4 into x, 4x is equal to y plus 1, y plus 8 1 is y plus 8. Y plus 8 1 is any number in 1 is same number or not, children. So like this comes. Now what you arrange, how you do arrange? X and Y bring into same side, number take into another side. Otherwise, let it be there. So, So I do this with the cross multiplication method. K. So here y bring into same side. 3x. X and h y should come. Plus y coming here. Minus y. Minus 3 let it be there. Is equal to 0. See, plus y coming here. X and h y write down. X and h y write down. Y and h number write down. That is the standard form of a pair of linear equation. Even here, 4x plus y coming here, minus y is equal to 8, or plus 8 coming here, minus 8 is equal to 0. See, everything same. See, 3x plus y coming here, minus y, minus 3 is already here. Okay, place change, whom you are doing, that sign will change. Even here, 4x plus y coming here, minus y, plus 8 coming here, minus 8. Is equal to 0. This is the pair of linear equations. So, this is equation number 1 and even equation number 2. Now, we have to solve this both equation for x and y. X and y you have to get. For that sake, what you do? What you have to do? Use cross multiplication method. See, cross multiplication to do 3x minus y minus 3 is equal to 0. 4x minus y minus 8 is equal to 0. Now, write x, even y, even 1. So, like this. Okay, children. Now, who is in the form of x? See, don't take. Remaining number here. Okay, remaining number is become 1 and even here 1. 2 number means 1 it is. So, write here 1 minus 1 minus 1. Minus 3, minus 8. This one. Minus 3, minus 8. 3, 4. Even here. 3, 4. Minus 1, minus 1. Like this you have to take. Okay, children? See, this one. Minus 1, minus 1. Minus 3, minus 8. Even here. Minus 3, minus 8. 3, 4. Even here. 3, 4, minus 1, minus 1. Like this, imagine and write. Is it okay? Now just cross multiply. Okay, so now see here. X, minus 8, minus 7. Into cross multiplication. Multiply the number first. 8 ones are 8. Minus into minus, plus. Middle sign is minus. Bracket, middle sign is minus. Then 3 ones are 3. Minus minus plus. Okay, so even here is equal to y by 4 threes are 12 minus 12. 4 threes are 12 minus 12. Middle sign is minus. Bracket. 8 threes are 24. Sign is minus. Is equal to 1 by 3 ones are 3 minus 3. Middle sign is minus. 4 ones are 4. 4 ones are 4 minus 4. Okay, children. So next step one. X, Y, 8 plus 2 minus minus 3 is equal to. Is equal to. Y write as is. Minus 12. Minus 2 minus. Plus 24. Is equal to 1 by minus 3 write as it is minus into minus plus 4. Okay, so now x by this remains, y by that is this 1 by this. So how can I do this? So here x by 8 minus 3, 1 plus 1 minus, you have to subtract. 8 minus 3 is 5 is equal to y by 1 plus 1 minus 12 subtract, 24 minus 12, 12. Even here is equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 minus 12 subtract, 4 minus 3, 1. So then compare first term with the last term, even second term with the last term to get the value of x and y. So x by 5 is equal to 1. Even y by 12 is equal to 1 by 1 is 1. Okay, now just drop it. So x is equal to 5 1s are 5. And y is equal to, cross it, 12 1s are 12. So the value of x and y I got is STL. X is numerator. Numerator is 5 and denominator is 12. So the fraction become 5 by 12. Okay, children? So fraction become 5 by 12. Therefore, the fraction. Therefore, the fraction is equal to x by 5. So fraction you have to find the fraction. So it is 5 by 12. 5 by 12. Okay? So like this, you can do this problem. Okay, hope you all understood. Okay, that's all about today's class. The next class, let us move to some more problems of exercise number 3.5. Till then, take care. Thank you.